Maria leaned against the car door and stared through the window at the harsh white lights spaced along the Lane Grove tunnel. The driver kept trying to start a conversation, but she'd caught a red-eyed flight and was beyond exhausted. All she wanted to do was get to her hotel and sleep for a lifetime. The traffic wasn't cooperating, though. It had been gridlocked for the last 20 minutes, and in the tunnel it seemed even worse. Maria didn't think they'd moved more than 10 meters in the last 5 minutes. "Bad traffic today, yeah?" The taxi driver, a cheerful man with a thick black beard, beamed at her through the rear vision mirror, and Maria mustered a thin smile. "Mm-hmm. Haven't seen it this bad in months. Must be a breakdown ahead." "Hmm." Maria turned to look out of the opposite window where she could see five other car lanes, two more going in their direction, the other three going the opposite, all forced to a halt. Every now and then a car would crawl a few inches closer to its leader, as though that would make any sort of difference. The radio came to life with a crackle, and Maria jumped. She'd nearly fallen asleep.
"We are currently experiencing an emergency situation," the voice on the radio said,
and Maria leaned forward to listen to it. Her driver hadn't touched the radio, she knew, by the way his face had gone pale. However, because the tunnel dipped below ground to carry cars from one side of the harbor to the other, the control room had the ability to activate the car's radio as an emergency.
"Remain in your vehicle,"
the voice said. He sounded flustered and panicky, though he was clearly reading from a script.
"Extinguish all lights and remain silent. Assistance will be sent as soon as possible."
The radio fell silent. Maria looked to her taxi driver, whose face had lost almost all color. He turned the key in the ignition, powered the car down, and killed its lights. Around her, the other cars were also being turned off. Maria swiveled in her seat to look behind her. She thought she could hear noises coming from deeper in the tunnel. Then the multitude of lights spaced along the concrete walls whined and died, plunging them into darkness. Someone shrieked and car door slammed. A handful of headlights were still on, and Maria tried to see what was happening through the limited glow, but everything was a mess of shadows and shapes. The radio crackled for a second time, and the voice returned. Its panic had risen to a near hysterical pitch, and he didn't seem to be reading from a script any longer.
"They say you should remain in your cars, but they're still finding you. Don't run. Don't bother. They'll catch you. They're spreading so fast. I've never seen or heard anything like this before. Oh, jeez. I'm so, so sorry. Stay in your cars."
The voice broke off with a gasp, and Maria heard a banging noise in the distance, followed by what sounded like metal being twisted and torn. Maria sat frozen in her seat as she stared at her driver. A car a few rows ahead turned on its hazard lights, and the flashing red reflected off the driver's face as he stared back. Then the screams started. Maria turned to look behind them and saw shapes, people, running between the cars. It was more than panic. It was pandemonium. Several figures shoved against her taxi as they ran past, making its way. Maria placed one hand on the car door, preparing to exit and join the crowd. But she stopped when she caught sight of other, larger shapes farther back in the tunnel. They were barely visible in the blinking hazard light, but they were definitely not human. The shapes moved on all fours, dexterously climbing over the cars and scuttling along the tunnel's walls. Their limbs had at least four joints each, and they were larger than an average man. They snatched up the fleeing humans so quickly that the motions were a blur. Maria heard the crackles and snaps of breaking bones underneath the screams. Glass smashed as the creatures pounded through car windows. "Get down," the taxi driver hissed, shoving Maria out of her seat so that she was kneeling in the footwell. She flattened herself as much as she could, trying to breathe through her mouth to minimize the noise. The taxi driver sunk back into a seat, his eyes wide as he tried not to shake. From her position, Maria could still see the figures racing past the windows and feel the impact as they bumped the car. Then the taxi shuddered as something large and heavy landed on it, and one of the running figures by her window was pulled from view with a gurgling shriek. Maria pressed her hand over her mouth and held her breath. They were enveloped by silence for a second. Then there was a horrific crash as the windshield was broken by a long, tough limb. The taxi driver barely managed half a scream before he was torn out of his seat and pulled through the hole in the windshield. His voice choked off then, and dark liquid splashed across the mirror above Maria. The sounds were changing as the screams faded into the distance. The human cacophony was replaced by steady, loud thuds as the creatures climbed over the cars, making snapping noises and chewing, tearing sounds. Maria squeezed her eyes closed so that she wouldn't have to watch the shadows move past the window. She kept still until the noises died into the distance and were eventually entirely extinguished. Her muscles ached from the cramped position. Outside, the tunnel remained dark, except for the hazard lights, which continued to bathe the area in intermittent flashes of red. She was surrounded in near-perfect silence. No footsteps, voices, thudding limbs, or tearing flesh. Maria shook as she slowly, cautiously rose to her knees. She peered through the car's window, between the streaks of blood, to see that the tunnel seemed empty. So did the cars. Their human occupants had been stripped from them, pulled through the broken windows or holes that had been carved in the metal. Maria alone had been spared, thanks to her hiding place. I've got to leave before these creatures come back. There should be emergency exits placed along the walls. They should be too small for those things to fit through easily. If I can just get to one of them. Maria opened the door slowly and silently. The car's interior lights automatically turned on in response. And Maria looked out, frozen in terror, as a dozen pairs of reflective, globe-like eyes turned towards her.
And now a word from our sponsors.
Boys and girls of every age, wouldn't you like to see something strange? Come with us and you will see. This our town of Halloween. This is
Vanitas. Vanitas. Spooktober 2023 is once again sponsored by Prestart Productions' favorite Venitas. Venitas is back again to take a little of the spook out of the Halloween season with their ghoulishly good gaming equipment and customer service so good, it's downright creepy. Venitas offers high-quality products that even the undead can get behind. You won't be haunted with nightmares as Venitas staff carefully packages all of their products so they will arrive to you in perfect condition after their journey through the underworld. If you're looking to upgrade your setup but want to do so in an affordable way, Venitas has some deadly good deals you won't be able to refuse. And as an added bonus, you will be awarded with a 10% discount on all orders if you use code PRESSSTARTMOM at checkout. So, don't be afraid. Go to Venitas.com today. You know you want to.